I've been watching pickup men for 65 years. And first of all, you've got to be dedicated to the horse world. And to Tyler and to Tucker, these are people who get up in the morning, normally all got a ranch job or a horse job, got a job. And then as they develop their skills, they become more proficient and the better the horses they ride. When you think about riding a horse that's smaller than some of the bucking horses and getting away with it, riding big horses and having to reach down on a small bucking horse, especially in the bareback riding, being able to rope bulls, being able to know how to rope a bull and not let your horse take a hooking.
Tyler, Shane Forge, all them guys, Tucker, Brent Sutton, all them guys taught me the world about handling horses, bucking horses, the horse you ride, the situation you're in with the cowboy.
He's someone I've admired because I know he knows horsepower, and I know he knows everything about rodeoing as a pickup man.
They're normally backing 4 to 5 head of horses. And some of the better horses that I've seen came off a ranch or they were rejects out of a bucking horse sale.
A lot of them I bought as problem horses nobody else get along with. They're a little bronky or bucky or just kind of hammerheaded a little bit, and it kind of takes that to do this job anyway, and I just got them from them and kind of just picking them up here and there, and I raised a few of them over the years.
Takes time to make a really good pickup horse. A lot of nights in the practice pen and a lot of hours out on the ranch and just seasoning them. So it's it ain't for everybody, but I sure enjoy it.
When you'd run up beside something that's jumping 4 foot in the air and kicking 4 foot above your head, and you, the closer you get to them, the better, or the fat, you know, that's pretty good adrenaline rush right there.
You know, when it comes to great pickup men and you talk about Tyler and Tucker, you've got to import those guys into the program every time you talk about great pickup men. Because I think there's one thing that's so very true that we say all the time, in the rodeo world, nobody gets rich, nobody gets famous, but everybody involved has a passion. And probably some of the most underestimated and underpaid guys in the world are pickup men, and the few women that are out there as well, because they're worth their weight in gold. They're worth so much more, and what they do is so, so very important. I think there's a really interesting dynamic, especially when we come to the Dakotas or up in the North Country, because here we'll have a lot of ranchers, a lot of cowboys, been on lots of horses, roped lots of cows, been out in the cold and done a lot of things that are sitting in those grandstands. They might have their arms crossed, they might talk to one another a little bit, and they may not, but they know the good rides and the fast runs when they see them. And the most, number one, respected cowboys in our business are the pickup men. It's because of what they do. It's because of who they are.
They're cattlemen. I wouldn't say they're as much as an entrepreneur, because there's a whole lot better jobs in the rodeo business for what it pays. And trucks and trailers and all night drives, 110 degrees in the summer, 30 below in the winter. I've seen them come right here to Minot, to 2 foot of snow and 20 below. And never ever hear one complain. It just seems like they're the silent lost heroes. They ride in, if you don't introduce them, they'll never say anything. If you brag on them too much, they'll come go, oh, you don't have to, you know, do that so much. 90% of them are most modest men in the world.
Tyler's going out in his prime. You know, he's not a guy that is crippled up or is too old to be doing it. You know, he's leaving on a high note, and I envy him for that. I don't think anybody will ever look back and say that there was maybe a better pickup man in this area. You know, he's one of the best in this area, and in my opinion, anywhere.
Tucker's an amazing cowboy and a good hand with a horse. I've seen him do things that shock me and make him look pretty good, and just try to emulate that and be in those positions to help cowboys when they're in a bind.
Yeah, I don't know what I'd say one thing to them. I felt real fortunate to work with them over the past few years, and like I said, they've all taught me something about a bucking horse or a rodeo or a certain situation. I was just super fortunate to be able to work with them over the years.
I've had a great career. I set a lot of goals and I accomplished them. But I'm just gonna miss getting to see your buddies. That's gonna be hard. That's gonna be the hardest of all.
Once you start doing it, I can't hardly quit doing it. But it's sure don't do it for the money. You gotta do it for the pleasure of it, I guess. You know, it's not a get rich scheme. I don't think with no wages cost so much to do it, but it's your fun.
Have your wife, your girlfriends, your family. It takes a lot of circled synergy over here to keep you in the circle synergy in the spotlight. And those have to coordinate and meet in the middle.
There's an old saying that if pickup men are doing their job right, you don't even know they're in the arena. And it's true. I mean, when things are going good, it's just smooth and quiet, and the job gets done and nobody knows it's even getting done.
There's so many people in those grandstands that respect who they are, what they do, in the quiet, mild manner, humble way that they just ease into position and do their job. Not necessarily about how well they take care of the cowboys that they sit on the ground, but maybe for a lot of these old ranchers with their arms crossed in the grandstands, how they handle the livestock. That's the truth in the pudding.
I think it's easy to say to Tyler and to Tucker, thanks guys, I know you're not through. I know you're not through saddling some big, strong, good boogers to ride. But your dedication to the rodeo business will not be forgotten. Somebody's gonna give you a saddle. I hope it's laced in gold. You both deserve it.
Well, you don't see me. Well, here to you, Tucker Stocklin in his retirement. Picking up for the last time here tonight. Here's a guy from Isabel, South Dakota that was born and raised to be a cowboy. And it is our way to say thank you. Elisa Fettig has got a beautiful handmade head stall just for you. Ladies and gentlemen, that man in the green shirt is a hero to all the young guys you see out in front of the bucking chutes. Won't you tell him thank you for 25 years of saving cowboys' lives? Every day we get to honor our heroes, but we're awfully glad we got to honor this hero here tonight. Sir, pleasure to know you. Thanks for playing so well for so long. We appreciate it. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, the gold watch going to Tucker Stocklin.
And tonight, inside that arena, I want to introduce you to one of the greatest cowboys and pickup men of all time. His dad put him on a horse at 12 years old, and he knew he wanted to be a cowboy. Since then, he has picked up all over the country, coast to coast, and border to border. 22 times the Badlands Circuit Pickup Man of the Year. He has worked for great rodeo companies like Corco, Burks, Wilson, Roy Limmel, Sutton, Servies, Brookman, and many Bronc Match committees. He was a two-time Bronc champion of the high school finals. And he did that until about 1998 when he decided his real job and passion was a pickup man. It is bittersweet, ladies and gentlemen, when we talk about retirement. Be on your feet for the one, the only, Mr. Tyler Robertson.
Still makes his living with his rope. As long as there's a sunset, he'll keep riding for the brand. You just can't see him from